Dear students, in this video, we are going to study the magnetic field strength due to a bar magnet at that point which lies on the equatorial line of the bar magnet. So suppose you have a bar magnet here. I already told you in the previous video that this will be the axial line of the bar magnet and this will be the equatorial line of the bar magnet. Now, if you have some point over the equatorial line and you want to find out magnetic field strength due to this bar magnet at this point, then how are you going to proceed? First of all, since you have a bar magnet here, suppose this is the south pole of the bar magnet, suppose this is the north pole of the bar magnet. I'll tell you why we usually draw south pole first and north pole the next order. Why cannot we simply write it north and south? Why it is written south and north? Because we are in a habit of reading left to right. Okay. Basically, what happens may it be an electric dipole or may it be a magnetic dipole. The directions of dipole moment are, see, if you have an electric dipole, then usually we draw minus Q first and plus Q the next, because the dipole moment, electric dipole moment, is directed from negative to positive charge. Similarly, if you have a bar magnet, then magnetic dipole moment is directed from south to north. तो क्या होता है कि हम उसी की direction में ही magnet बना देते हैं, so that it becomes easier to compare the things. Okay, so after that, if this is the magnetic dipole moment, this is the distance of separation between them, and this is the point where you want to find out net magnetic field intensity. So how are you going to proceed? पहली बात तो ये center होगा, okay? And suppose कर लो center का distance from the point P is equal to small d, okay? So after that, this is L. And this is also L. OS is L and ON is L, because O is the center of these two poles. So if this is D, this is L, apply Pythagoras theorem and you are left with under root D square plus L square, which is the value of PS. Similarly, the value of PN is under root D square plus L square. So क्या करना है आपने? पहले इस साउथ पोल के वजह से इस पॉइंट P पर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी फाइंड आउट करनी है. देन ड्यू टू दिस नॉर्थ पोल यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एट पॉइंट P. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल B वेक्टर विल बी इक्वल टू, ड्यू टू साउथ पोल, आई एम राइटिंग ड्यू टू साउथ पोल, इट विल बी इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट अपॉन 4 pi. पहली बात तो आपने यहाँ पे यूनिट नॉर्थ पोल रखना है, ओके? सो पोल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ साउथ पोल विच इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एन, पोल स्ट्रेंथ एट पीक विच इज इक्वल टू प्लस 1 डिवाइडेड बाई अंडर रूट डी स्क्वायर प्लस एल स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर. बी इक्वल्स टू म्यू नॉट अपॉन 4 pi एम डी स्क्वायर प्लस एल स्क्वायर. I hope it's clear. And what will be the direction? Since it's a unit north pole and this is a south pole, so that unit north pole will be attracted towards the south pole, because opposite poles attract each other. So this will be the direction of B vector. This will be the direction of B vector along PS. I hope it's clear. Similarly, now you are going to find out magnetic field intensity due to north pole over the point P, and you have kept unit north pole at the point P. So that will be P dash equals to mu naught upon 4 pi the strength of this pole multiplied by the strength of this pole, which is plus 1 upon under root D square plus L square whole square. So this will be mu naught upon 4 pi m upon d square plus l square. So magnitude is coming out to be the same, but सिंस नॉर्थ पोल एंड यूनिट नॉर्थ पोल दे आर लाइक पोल्स सो दे आर गोइंग टू रिपेल ईच अदर एंड व्हेन दे आर गोइंग टू रिपेल ईच अदर दिस यूनिट नॉर्थ पोल विल बी मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन अलोंग दिस डायरेक्शन डायरेक्टेड अवे फ्रॉम दिस नॉर्थ पोल सो इट्स काइंड ऑफ गेटिंग रिपेल्ड नो सो This point P is facing one magnetic force over here and the other magnetic force over here. So we need to find out their resultant. We'll complete the parallelogram. I'll explain this procedure. We'll complete the parallelogram. This diagonal will be giving us net magnetic field intensity. Okay? I hope it's clear. After that, If this angle is theta, this angle will also be equal to theta. Why? Because these are two parallel lines and this is a transversal and these two are alternate angles. And if this angle is theta, this will be also equal to theta, corresponding angles. Now we are going to resolve. When you will resolve B vector into two components, it will be B cos theta here. And B sine theta here. Similarly, if you will resolve B dash into two components, B dash cos theta over here and B dash sine theta over here. अभी क्या है कि B और B dash का magnitude तो same है. So जब आप values put करोगे, suppose you are getting 10 value, 10 directed over here and 10 directed over here. And these two are vector quantities, so they are going to cancel each other's effect. So B sine theta and B dash sine theta are going to cancel each other. And what you will be left with, you will be left with these two things, which can be added up. B cos theta plus B dash cos theta. And this will give your net magnetic field. So B net. B and B dash have the same magnitude as I have already told you. So take it common. So this will become 2B cos theta. So 2B mu naught upon 4 pi m upon d square plus l square. Okay, what is cos theta? Cos theta is this triangle's base upon hypotenuse. Base is l upon hypotenuse is d square plus l square under the root. So this becomes mu naught into m divided by d square plus l square raised to the power 3 by 2 and 4 pi also. So solve it and if the magnet is a very short magnet, l can be ignored and you are going to get mu naught m upon 4 pi dq. I hope it's clear. The derivations are somewhere similar to electric dipole.